For some Jews, the placing of eggs next to a source of heat on the Sabbath is considered breaking the law. The reason? The egg could get a little cooked, and it is unlawful to cook on their sacred day. It is unlawful for a tailor to go out on the Sabbath with a needle in his clothes. The reason? A tailor uses a needle for work. It is not lawful to carry tools on the Sabbath. Sound ridiculous? We thought so too. So we talked with Malachiah Bar Pashur, a respected Pharisee in Jerusalem, about their laws.
Just placing an egg by a fire, a needle in a tunic. Could these small acts really be a violation of the law?
Oh, yes, they are. God has given his law, and we must keep it.
But why are you so overly concerned about the little things? How can you even enjoy life?
Enjoying life is not even the issue here. Not sinning before God is the issue. Salvation depends upon keeping the law. If a person doesn't live the law perfectly, he is accursed. We can't be clean in his sight unless we remain clean by not sinning.
Are the examples we showed written in your scriptures as laws of God?
Well, many things are written in our scriptures, but the examples you mention are part of the oral law or traditions of the elders.
I've heard you sometimes miss the intent of the law of Moses by using the oral law for loopholes.
You heard wrong.
Well, don't you have a loophole that says you don't have to support your aging parents with your money? Which is in direct violation of one of your Ten Commandments.
If the money is set aside for God, it can't be used for other purposes. What do you know about our law?
The basis for the Jewish law is the law given by Moses. This oral law, or the traditions of the elders, as it is sometimes called, has been added and seems to go further than the original written law. This oral law is almost like building a fence around the law of Moses, so that there's no chance of breaking it. But there is a group of Jewish leaders that don't agree with the Pharisees about this oral law. They are the Sadducees.
As you see, we are bound only by the written law of Moses. The oral law is not binding on us. Anything not in the written law of Moses does not concern us.
The Pharisees say that Jews should not mix with Romans. Some of the criticism I've heard of you Sadducees has to do with your wealth and political connections with the Romans.
I am tired of the barbs from the Pharisees. They are just jealous because we wield the political power. We are the only ones capable of smoothing out relations with the government.
I was surprised to find out how much the Pharisees and Sadducees disagree. They even disagree on basic doctrines such as resurrection and spirits.
Another group of influential Jewish leaders, the scribes, are looked to as authorities on the law. Most scribes are Pharisees, but there are some Sadducean scribes. These scribes develop the law and apply specific rules to the modern circumstances. Written